Hello, I have another Mackie TH12A speaker for repair here, this time with a different problem. Let's get straight to it. I prepared the setup to show the problem. I connected the speaker to the left channel, and here I have a test.
Front, left.
And there is no problem with low volume, but listen what happens when I increase the volume.
Front, left.
Still no problem.
Front, left.
There you go. With this volume, we can already hear that it starts to cut out.
Front, left.
And this happens with the woofer. There is no problem with the tweeter.
Front, left.
And now let's try with a copyright-free music from YouTube library. There is no problem at this volume, but I will increase it a little. There you go. Slightly less volume, no problem, but let's increase again. And there you go. I'm almost sure I know what's going on here. Most probably the woofer is damaged, and it happens when a speaker is run at very high volumes for a long time, essentially overloaded for quite some time, so the voice coil in the woofer overheats and develops shorts between the turns. And depending how many turns are shorted, the problem can be very pronounced, like in this case, which means we start hearing the problem at moderate volumes. Or it can happen rarely at very high volumes. So I guess we will find that the resistance of the voice coil in the woofer is much lower than it should be. Let's say less than a half, guessing from how pronounced the problem is in this case. So let's take the speaker apart and check. Here I took the woofer out. It was quite easy. Just three screws holding the grill and four bolts holding the woofer. There are four metal inserts in the plastic. And by the way, the polarity is important. So this wire with black mark on it is negative. Let's have a look at this woofer. It is Eminence 12-inch 8-ohm woofer, made in China, engineered in the USA. Now let's measure this thing. We should not expect 8 ohms exactly. Usually at DC it is a bit lower, let's say around 7 ohms. Sometimes it is specified in the datasheet. So let's see how this guy is doing. And there you go, 0.8 ohms. Yes, this thing is dead. And just out of curiosity, let's double check with the LCR meter at 1 kHz. .36 ohms, and I hear this 1 kHz tone, but it is very faint. So what happens is that the amplifier IC has protection in it from overload, and this low resistance creates an overload condition. When volume goes up, protection kicks in at some point and cuts the power. Then protection recovers, and that produces the effect that we have heard. Here I happen to have this cheaper replacement woofer, which is a GRS 12PF8, also 12-inch 8-ohm woofer, and I believe it has the same mounting holes and the same connectors here, so potentially it can be used in this speaker. But for now, let's just check for comparison. Let's see how this one is doing. And there you go, around 7.5 ohms at DC. And let's check at 1 kilohertz. There you go, around 10 ohms. And we can hear this 1 kilohertz tone. So this is what we should expect from a good one. Here I found this woofer on full compass, exactly the same part number here, and it looks exactly the same, and the price is $73.45 with free shipping. Not cheap at all, and unfortunately there are no specs, only these two numbers here, 125 watt 8 ohm. And it must be the cheapest Eminence speaker, because I couldn't find it on the Eminence website, and the lowest model here is Alpha 12A, which is a bit more powerful, 150 watt. And if we have a look at the specs, just to have some idea, look, the resistance here is 6.3 ohm, and the sensitivity is 95.6 dB, which is very, very good. And for comparison, look at this GRS 12 PF8. The regular price is $19.99, and it seems to be on sale for $15.88, plus some shipping, of course. And here are the specs. It is 120 watt woofer, 87 dB sensitivity, so it seems to be a little less powerful, a little less sensitive, and there are some other differences, of course. Look, DC resistance here is 7.56 ohms, the coil inductance is different, Q is different, and perhaps frequency response is quite different, so they are not exactly the same, of course. And I would recommend getting the Eminence woofer, of course, but on a tight budget, I think this should do as well, especially if you don't plan to run the speaker at the highest volume. I found this Alpha 12A on Sweetwater for $69.99 and free shipping as well. So I think it's better to get this one, because it seems to be a slightly upgraded model, slightly more powerful, and that means it is less likely to die from overload. It turns out that the holes are slightly off. They need to be a tiny bit farther apart, perhaps a millimeter or so. I'm sure this can be done by enlarging the holes a little bit or something like that, but I'm not going to bother for this test. I put the speaker on a couple of blocks of wood so I could attach the cables on the back and run it in this horizontal position just to test. The woofer is not attached at the moment, and it's going to vibrate at high volume. But other than that, there is no problem. Let's have a listen. There you go. And that vibration goes away if I press down at the woofer frame with my hands. So it seems to be working fine, no problem at all. And I'm not going to wait for the Eminence speaker to finish this video. I believe we have seen all that matters. And I hope, as usually, that this was interesting and useful for someone. If you think so too, give it a thumbs up, subscribe and share. Thank you very much. Bye.